through a prism, then how it will refract and we'll also find out at the end the relationship between the angle of incidence, angle of deviation with respect with our refractive index of that prism. Here only we will be discussing about a triangular base prism. That means here the base of the triangle, sorry, the base of the prism will be a triangle. So let us see this diagram. Suppose let us consider a triangular base prism. Let the name of the base is our KB. So outer one is the rarer medium, this one is the rarer medium, and this one is the denser medium. Means the material of the prism is denser as compared to the outside. So if any light ray is incident, suppose a light ray is incident on the face AB. Okay. So if the prism will not be present, then this light will pass straight, this will be the original part. But due to the presence of the prism, it will refract. So let the light is traveling now in this direction. So after refracting from the face AB, now the light is incident on the face AC, and you can see that here the light is traveling from the denser to the rarer. Okay, we can draw a normal here on the face AB, and you can see that the light is bent towards the normal because it is traveling from the rarer to denser. So similarly, if you draw a normal here on the face AC, then the light will move away from the normal because it is moving from rarer to denser medium. And this one is the angle of incidence, that is the I, and this one is the angle of refraction or the emergence, let it be E, because light is emerging out, making this angle with the normal. So angle of emergence. Let this point and the two normals intersect, name it as N. In this direction, okay, let the incident ray is our P, then this is our Q point, and this one is our R, and this is S. RS is the emergent light ray. Okay. Now you can see that the original path of the light is in this direction. And due to the presence of the prism, the light is moving in this direction. So you can say that there is a deviation in its path. So if you join this one, this angle, let it be this is M point, when this light is ray is intersecting this light ray, let it be M point. And this one is the angle of deviation, let it be delta. Delta is the angle of deviation through which the light is deviated from its original path. And let this angle is R1 and this angle is R2. So now we will derive a relationship between this refractive index and that angle of deviation and angle of incidence. Or you can say that we will find out an expression to find out the refractive index of this material of the prism. Okay. Then, now we see the rectangle, this A, Q, N, and R. Here, this angle A, Q, N is 90 degree and A, R, N is also 90 degree. Then, we can see that this angle A and this angle Q and R, if you add, this will also give you 180 degree, because we know that the sum of the four angles of a rectangle is 360 degree. So these two angles are 90, 90, 180 degree. So this one will be also 180 degree. So in the rectangle AQNR, if you are the angle A plus the angle QNR, the value will come 180 degree. This is equation number 1. And remember that this angle, this A, this angle is known as the angle of the prism. If I define what is the angle of prism, then you can see that this is the refracting surface and this is also the refracting surface. In this base prism, in this base, AB and AC are the refracting surfaces. So the angle made by the two refracting surfaces is known as the angle of the prism. If your AB and BC will be the refracting surface, then this ABC will be the angle of the prism. Remember, the angle made by the two refracting surfaces is known as the angle of prism. So this A is the angle of prism here. Then you can see that this triangle QNR, in the triangle QNR, this R1 plus R2 plus QNR will also give you 180 degree, because the summation of the three angles of a triangle is also 180 degree. So in the triangle QNR, R1 plus R2 plus QNR is also 180 degree. Then now you can see this equation number 1 and equation number 2. From these two equations, you can easily say that A, value of A is equal to your R1 plus R2. Because this QNR is common in both the equations. So A, value of the angle A will be your R1 plus R2. Okay. Now you see this delta. This delta is the angle of deviation. And if you see the triangle Q, R and M, you just see the triangle Q, R and M. In the triangle Q, R, M, this delta is the exterior angle. So the value of the delta will be equal to your M, Q, R plus M, R, Q. Okay. So I can write now the value of the delta will be equal to is the summation of angle M, Q, R plus summation of the angle MRQ, because this is the exterior angle and the value of the exterior angle is the sum of the two interior angles. So now we have to find out what is the value of MQR and MRQ. You see this angle and this angle. From symmetry you can see that these are the two lines, they are intersecting. This is I, that means this total angle is also I. And if it is R1, then this angle is our I minus R1. Means the value of the angle MQR is our I minus R1. Similarly, in this side also you can see that this ray and this one, they are intersecting each other, and this angle is, total angle is E, this one and this one. So this total angle is also E, and this one is R2, that means this angle will be, the value of this one will be your E minus R2. So now you can write that MQR is coming I minus R1 plus MRQ. m r q is coming e minus r q. Then you can see that the expression for the delta will become I plus e minus a, because this r1 plus r2 will be your a. You can see that this will become I plus e. If you take minus common, then it will become minus 1 into r1 plus r2, and r1 plus r2 is our a. So the expression for the angle of deviation delta is coming I plus e minus a. Okay, so these are the two required equations I will be using later. So I am just writing it down here. A is equal to r1 plus r2. This one is our equation number 3. And delta is equal to our I plus E minus A. This is our equation number 4. Okay. So now we'll get to the case of the minimum deviation. Means when this deviation, this delta, will be minimum. That condition we will see. For minimum deviation, you just remember the light will suffer minimum deviation when passing through a prism if your I will be equal to E, means the angle of incidence should be equal to your angle of emergence. First condition. And this condition also implies that your R1 should be equal to R2. R1 is the angle of refraction in the second in the first surface, that is AB, and R2 is the angle of incidence of the surface SC. So R1 must be equal to your R2, and I should be equal to your E, and this light ray, the refracted ray which is passing through the prism, this QR must be parallel to the base of the prism. This one is the another condition, that our in this diagram our QR, the light ray which is passing through the prism, must be parallel to the base of the prism, that is BC. So these are the three required conditions for this angle should become the minimum. The deviation will be minimum, small. So now we will use these two conditions, that I is equal to E and R1 is equal to your R2, in this equation 3 and 4. And by using this equation, values of these two conditions, equation 3 and 4, we will find out the value of I and R. R means that angle of emergence. E we have to find out. What is that angle of incidence and what is that angle of refraction? Because we are going to calculate the refractive index of the prism. So we need to find out I and R so that we can use our Snell's law. So if I use this equation, this one, the first condition in equation 3, this condition. Now equation 3 will become, if your R1 is equal to R2, then A will be equal to your R plus R. Let us consider that your R1 is equal to R2, let it be R. So this R1 is equal to R2, let it be R, then it will become R plus R, that is 2R. So this implies that A is coming 2R, or your R is coming A by 2. Equation number 5. Similarly, now if I use this one, that measurement of I is equal to measurement of E, I is equal to E. In this case, in the equation number 4, this is delta I write then dm minimum deviation. Now equation 4 becomes dm minimum deviation. I am not writing delta again, now I am just write dm, means the delta changes to dm. So dm will become I plus E minus A. So you can see that I is equal to E, so I can write this is I plus I minus A. So this implies that your dm is coming 2I minus A, or your I will become A plus dm by 2. The value of the I, angle of incidence, is coming A plus dm by 2, where A is the angle of the prism and D is the angle of minimum deviation divided by 2. So now I will use the Snell's law for the surface AB. The light is traveling from rarer to denser medium. Then by using Snell's law, we need these two values of I and R. From Snell's law, our N21 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to sin I by sin R. So this implies that N21 is equal to sin I. I is our A plus dm by 2 whole divided by sin R. R is our A by 2. So this one is the required expression to find out the refractive index of the material of the prism, that N21 is equal to sin A plus dm by 2 by sin A by 2. So this is the required equation or expression to find out the refractive index of the material of the prism, where A is the angle of the prism, D is the angle of minimum deviation, and N21 is the refractive index of this material of the prism with respect to outside. It is medium 1 and that one is the medium 2. You have to remember this expression. Okay. Now, if you plot the graph between the angle of incidence and the angle of deviation, this is delta, angle of deviation, and this is I. If you plot a graph between the angle of incidence and angle of deviation, then the nature of the graph will be like this. Okay. So this one will be the nature of the graph if you draw a plot a curve between the I versus D, angle of incidence and angle of deviation. And you can see that this graph represents that when you are increasing the angle of incidence, the value of the angle of deviation is decreasing, and there comes a particular value of the angle of incidence here. In this case, the deviation is minimum. This is our dm, angle of deviation. And after the minimum deviation, if you are further increasing the angle of incidence, the angle of deviation also increases. This is the nature of the graph. First, with the increase in angle of incidence, the angle of deviation will decrease and it will become minimum. Then, again it will increase the angle of incidence, again the angle of deviation will increase. And you can remember, just you can see, if I draw another one, this is the angle of deviation. Suppose, if I consider this one, this particular angle of deviation, here and here. The values are same. If let it is the 30 degree, so in this point the angle of deviation is 30 degree, and in this point also the angle of deviation is 30 degree. And you can see that for the same angle of deviation, we are having two angle of incidence values. For this angle of incidence, the angle of deviation will be 30 degree, suppose. And for this angle of incidence also, the angle of deviation will be the same 30 degree. So remember that apart from this minimum deviation, if you consider any value of the angle of incidence, sorry, angle of deviation, there are two values of angle of incidence you will get. But for minimum deviation, only one value is there. For only one angle of incidence, there will be minimum deviation. For any other deviation, you will get two values of angle of incidence. So this graph is very, very important. Okay. Come back to this expression that N21 is equal to sin A plus Dm by 2 by sin A by 2. This is the formula to find out the refractive index of the material of the prism. Then now, if the angle of the prism is very small, for a very small angle prism, then I can say that this N21 will be equal to our A plus Dm by 2 by A by 2. Because for small angle prism, our sin theta, which is very small, we know that the sin theta is nearly equal to theta for very small angles. Then you can see that here this will become N21 A minus A is equal to Dm. Or the expression for the minimum deviation will come N21 minus 1 whole into A. You can take A from common from here. This will become N21 minus 1 whole into A is equal to Dm. So this is the formula for the deviation for a small angle prism.